Today, we will discuss an important concept called stop words in NLP. Let's look at our same example that we discussed in the last video, which is you have news articles and you want to tag or auto tag the company name. And how do you do that? Well, when you are reading the article, you notice certain words such as Elon Musk, Gigafactory, Model 3. If you encounter those words, you know this is Tesla. If you encounter Apple, iPhone, those kind of words, you know that the news article is about Apple. And this is a classic problem that they solve in NLP world, where they try to auto extract entity or they try to tag the topics to a news article. And this approach is called bag of words, which is something we already discussed in the last video, where let's say you have three articles, you don't know which company the article is from. And if you can build simple bag of words model, where bag of words is a jargon, it's very simple thing actually. You have a word and you count number of words. So in first article, Tesla appeared 14 times, Model 3 appears 9 times. And it's obvious this is a Tesla company, right? And based on, see, the second article, iPhone appeared 13 times, iPad appears 6 times, and remaining words are 0, etc. You know it is about Apple. But if you read the article carefully, you'll find a lot of other words as well, such as wants, time, to, prepare. So, see, I represented a very simple model here, you know, very convenient model. In reality, you will have a lot of noise. You'll have to, for, over. And these words are general English words which can appear in any article with an equal frequency. Based on these word count, you can't determine if the article is from Tesla or Apple. Wouldn't it be nice if we can filter these words? So let's say I'm looking at this article and some common words which appear in pretty much all the articles, like to, from, the, a, and, or. If you can remove that, you can make your bag of words model little less sparse. So sparse means in this model, you have a lot of noise. The vocabulary is very big, computation time is high, it's a sparse model. Whereas if you remove these words, your model will get simpler and you will be focusing on things that you care about. Okay, so if you have this kind of model, it's better. So these words are called stop words. And it's a common practice that during pre-processing stage in NLP pipeline, majority of the time, they remove stop words. Now, there are certain occasions where they don't remove it and we'll look into that. For example, let's say you're doing sentiment classification and you have, this is a good movie, this is not a good movie. But when you remove stop words, what you will get as a result is good movie, good movie. This might be a little, you know, incorrect because not, N-O-T, is a stop word. So if you remove that, and if you process remaining sentence, you can run into issue. However, for sentiment classification, you will see things like, this is a worst movie, okay? There are some people who will say this is not a good movie, but majority of the time, this problem doesn't arise. But I want to just tell you so that you keep this thing in mind, just in case you are using stop words and you are not getting expected results for your NLP application. When you're doing language translation, let's say, how are you doing the world? I translate that into Telugu. If I remove stop words in the pre-processing stage, all I will get is Dhaval. And you can't translate Dhaval to Telugu by keeping the meaning of original sentence same. So you have to use common sense and look at a given NLP problem. It's a machine translation, it's a sentiment classification, what kind of problem it is. And based on that, you use stop words removal technique during pre-processing stage. Stop word removal is actually common in many applications, but applications like this, machine translation. Another one is chatbot, right? Someone is asking a question. I don't find a yoga mat on your website. Can you help? If you remove stop words in pre-processing phase, all you get is find yoga mat website help. What does that mean? You know, it doesn't capture the essence of the questions in a right way. So these are some of the examples where you have to be careful about not removing the stop words, but in majority of the other cases, removing stop words during pre-processing stage is a common practice. Let's do some coding now. As usual, I have created a new notebook, imported Spacey, and by doing this from spacey.lang.en.stopwords, import stopwords, you can look at all the stopwords which are there in this English model. So you see that a, all, alone, back, cannot. These are commonly used terms in English, and removing them prior to building your actual model will give you a lot of benefit. And there are 326 of them in total. Now let me create a new doc in our usual style and see how this thing works. So I will just create simple document here, and then you can go token by token. So from for token in doc, and there is this method called isStop. So this will tell you if the given token is a stop word or not. And if you print that token, see, these are all the stop words. And what people do is they define some function called, let's say, preprocess, where you give a text as an input. And this is a common practice in NLP application. And you want to do all preprocessing here. So preprocessing means removing stop words, taming, lemmatization, things like that. So here I will say doc is equal to NLP text for token in doc if token dot is stop. You know what I'll do? I will remove it. So if you want to remove it, you'll say if not token. So that's a reverse. If it is not a stop word, then maybe store this in some kind of array. Okay. And the better way of doing this in Python is using list comprehension. So I will say here, I want to use list comprehension, and I will say no stop words, and that is equal to, see, you get your for loop here first, and before the for loop you will say token dot text. So token dot text is what you want in this list as a final thing, and your if condition you specify here. This is how you write the list comprehension. Okay, and you can return no stop words. And then I can do preprocessing of this text, and it will print me all the tokens just by skipping this thing, the stop words. Now see, you can have things like comma, so you can remove that as well by saying and not token dot is, there is a punctuation mark, right? This is a punctuation mark. I don't want to care about punctuation mark, and it will remove that. See, there was a comma punctuation mark which got removed. So we can try a few other statements. For example, my most favorite one is this. You see, the other is not, these were all stop words, and it removed that. Checking our article on Tesla, right? You can have this big sentence, but when you remove stop words, you want only the terms that you care about, which is Musk, wants, time, prepare. I know some of these are not even useful, wants, etc., but that's okay. At least we removed the most common ones. Now, how do you apply this pre-processing function on a pandas data frame? Let's say one of the common use case in machine learning is you load your data in pandas data frame, and then you want to build an NLP model. Now you want to do pre-processing on top of it. So what I'm going to do here is I have taken this particular data set. So let me show you. So these are all the cases in Department of Justice USA from 2009 to 2018. These are all the press releases, okay? And the database is in JSON format. So see, there is some court case. So it's basically a press release of some court case. The the verdict that court gave, and so on. And these are the content of the case. This is a title, things like that. So I have taken this data set from Kaggle and I have placed I have downloaded that JSON file, and then that JSON file I am going to import in Pandas by doing this. If you don't know Pandas, in YouTube search Code Basics Pandas, you will find my tutorials. So here, when you say lines true, there is one line per one JSON object. Okay, so when you load this, what you'll find is 13,000 records basically. And let me print first 5 records. So see, these are all the cases, and what I have is case ID, the title, the actual content, big press release date, and the topics. Now, some of the topics are empty. So let's say I'm building a model to auto extract topics. That's my NLP application that I'm building. I can filter all the articles which don't have any topic. Okay. And the way you do that is, see, the type of this df.topics, if you look at df.topics 0, for example, right, the type of this thing is list. Okay, so df.info, if you do df.info, it will also tell you a few things. These are all the exploratory methods that you use to kind of go over it. But anyways, we know that the topics type is list, and you want to filter it. So how do you filter it? So you might have seen this in my Pandas tutorial, that you can use your filtering condition here in this square bracket. So you can say df is equal to filtering condition that you specify in this bracket. And what is my filtering condition? So you can say df.topics. Okay, so let's see. I want to say whenever df.topics is an empty list, okay, filter that. And one way of doing this could be, okay, you write maybe some lambda function, you check the length of the list. Or there is an easier way, which is you convert this to str and you check the length. This is a ready-made function that Pandas provide. And whenever this length is not zero, which means list has some content, you get that. So now when you do df.head first 5, see, you have filtered all those rows which had empty list in our topics. And then your Pandas data frame is only 4,000 rows. Initially it was 13,000 rows. So by the way, by doing this exercise, I'm just showing you how would you apply stop word removal when you're dealing with a real database. Okay, so this pre-processing function is kind of a simple function that works fine on one string, but usually when you are doing any building any NLP application, many cases you will have Pandas data frame. So I just want to demonstrate. We are not going to build any machine learning model in this tutorial. I just want to demonstrate how you apply pre-processing function on a Pandas column. And to keep things simple and fast, I will just take first 100 rows of my data frame. Only first 100, because I want to show pre-processing and I can do it on a smaller data set, right? And now when I do df.shape, only 100 rows, okay? And now on the contents, see, I have this contents, right? This contents. If you look at this contents, it is this, and this is the ID. So let's say 4 is the ID. So if you do iloc 4, you'll be able to print, see, this big paragraph. And this big paragraph, look at the length. And what I want to do is, I want to remove all the stop words from this so that this length can be reduced and I can build effective, simple NLP application out of this. Okay, so let's remove stop words from this column. From this entire column, stop words I want to remove, right? So like for the, see, all these stop words in Pandas. So I will do, let's say I will create I want to maintain that column and I want to create a new column called contents new. And you all know, if you have an existing column, you can use apply function to create a new column. And on this existing column, I want to apply my pre-process function, because pre-process function is already defined, you see. And by the way, I don't want array to be back. I want the string to be back. So if you want to convert this list or array into string in Python, you just do simply join. So when you do this join, it will take all the list elements and create a string out of it. Right now you're getting a list, you will get now a string, see? So that's the effect of doing this. So my preprocess function now takes input string, remove all the stop words, returns another string. And when I do that, that's what is gonna happen. And I can print the first five elements. Based on your computer and the size, data size, it may take time. We have only 100 elements, so it came back pretty fast. And you see this new contents new. And you will see things like, see, here it says 130 count criminal incident was, you see was released. So see here was is removed. And if you want to see it a little further, what you can do is, see this length was 5504, but if you look at new content, see 4217. So 5504 minus 4217 were stop words, it removed all of them. And if you want to print these things, let's print it. So contents new is after removing your stop words. So now see, what you have is 21st, let me just print, you know, first 300 characters or so that it's readable. So see 21st century and, so see and is removed, off is gone, it is gone, agreed, affiliates, all these things are gone. Hooray, you just wrote a function to remove stop words and also you did this thing in Pandas data frame. So that's all I have for this video. Keep on checking video description, folks, because many times I add exercise after 1 or 2 weeks of publishing the video. Sometimes I add it later also. This is a community of four. For example, see, let me just show you Core Basics NLP. When I was doing this video, I did not have the exercise, okay? But later on, Kiran Marala, he's a community contributor, he helped me build this exercise. So now there is this exercise for bag of words and there is exercise solution also. So you can look at the solution, but I know you all are sincere students. You will not look at the solution unless you have tried it on your own. So for today's video also, if you want to contribute, just fork the GitHub repo and make changes and give me a pull request. I will look into it. But yes, my idea is to have exercises available for all the videos at some point of time, if not at the time of publishing. I wish you all the best. Thank you for watching.